We're going to have a little discussion about horizontal and vertical lines. And first, let's start with horizontal lines. So what can you say about the rate of change of a horizontal line? Well, its rate of change is zero. The reason is because it's neither increasing nor decreasing. Therefore, we call it a constant function. So let's look at some examples of horizontal lines. Y equals 5 would be an example. This would be a function that has all y values of 5 associated with a variety of different x values. Graphically, it would look like this, a horizontal line that goes through the y-axis at 5. Another example, using our function notation, is f of x equals negative 17. That would be a graph that has all y values of negative 17. If that's the case, then what is f of 4? Well, f of 4 is negative 17. What about f of negative 10,012? Well, that's negative 17 also, because no matter what the output will always be negative 17. Let's talk about vertical lines. First off, is the graph of a vertical line a function? It's not a function. It does not pass the vertical line test, but it is a set of ordered pairs that satisfy a particular condition. For example, x equals 4 is an example of a vertical line. Here's its graph. Notice all the x values are 4. X equals negative 11 would be a graph whose x values are all negative 11. Notice that we always have the same x value associated with multiple y values. So one input associated with an infinite amount of outputs, and thus it is not a function.